So in the last module, I showed you how we can use conditions to do things like calculating our taxes. Well, it turns out calculating the taxes in Canada is a little more complicated than that. One aspect is what the price is, but we also charge different taxes in different provinces across the country. So sometimes I have multiple conditions and I need to figure out what's the correct action. So let's say you're in the province of Alberta or Nunavut, then you actually have a tax rate of 5% in Canada. And if you're in the province of Ontario, then the tax rate is 13%. So it's a big difference. You have to make sure you calculate it correctly. So I could write multiple if statements. Say, if the province is Alberta, set the tax to 5%. If the province is Nunavut, set the tax to 5%. If the province is Ontario, set the tax to 13%. This will work, but there's a more elegant way to do it. And that is using something called Elif. Because in this case, only one of these conditions will ever happen. The province is never going to be equal to Alberta and Ontario at the same time. It's going to be one or the other. That's when you want to go with Elif. It allows me to say, hey, check if province is Alberta. It's not? Then check the next condition. So else. So otherwise, if the province is none of it. Oh, what, it's not? Then check the next condition. If province is Ontario, then check that one. So basically, it'll go down the list, and when it finds one that's a match, it'll set the tax to the appropriate rate and exit the if statement right there. So the Elif allows me to do a little more efficient way of checking code. It's great if only one of the conditions will ever be met. Still need that colon at the end of each statement. The other advantage to using the Elif is it allows you to put that default action in there as well. So I have that ability to say, hey, for these provinces there's a specific rate, but for everybody else there's a default tax rate of 15%. So now I can just add an else statement and say, if it's Alberta, here's what you do. If it's none of it, here's what you do. If it's Ontario, this is what you do. If it's anything else, just set the tax to 15%. So the other advantage to an Elif is I can have that default else action. Now, if you have more than one condition that causes the same action, you can actually combine those together. So in this case, Alberta and Nunavut actually have the same tax rate. So what I can do is I can use an or to say, if the province is Alberta or province is equal to Nunavut, tax should be set to 5%. So this again just saves me some time because I have multiple conditions causing the same output. I can use things like an or statement to say if it's one or the other, then give me this following output. Now, the way or statements work is if the first condition is true and the second condition is true, the condition evaluates as true. What it really comes down to with or statements is pretty easy. If any one of the conditions is true, then the entire statement will be evaluated as true. So in this case, if the province is Alberta, tax will be set to 5%. If the province is none of it, set the tax to 5%. It doesn't matter which one is true. If any of them is true, it will set the tax to 5%. For it to, say, set the tax to anything else, then it cannot be Alberta or it can, and it's not none of it either. So it has to be neither one of them. So this is what we call a truth table that shows how the or statements are evaluated. If you have a list of values to check, there's actually a neat little shortcut for this specific situation. There's something called the in operator. And basically, it's for those situations when you find yourself saying, if it equals this, or it equals this, or it equals this, or it equals this. In that case, you can use something called an in. So it turns out, and this is actually true, there's actually three places in Canada which all have the same tax rate. So I can say, if province in this list, Alberta, none of it, or Yukon. So if it's any one of those three values, set the tax to 5%. I could have done that with an or statement, perfectly valid, but I find the in statement a little bit tidier to work with. But it's up to you. Effectively, they do the same thing. Now, what about when an action depends on a combination of conditions? Let's say you're visiting Canada, but you don't live there. Well, you don't necessarily have to pay the taxes. That's that whole concept of things being duty-free when you're moving from one place to another. So we won't charge you the taxes if you're visiting. So we might need to say, hey, if the country is Canada, so if you're a Canadian making this purchase, and the province is equal to the following, charge this tax rate. But if you're not a Canadian, well, then we're going to set the tax to zero. We want you to come to the country and buy some awesome things, but you don't have to pay to maintain our roads. So you can do nesting if statements. So what I have here is I have an if statement, and inside the if statement is another if statement. Now, I'm not just making those spaces, those four space and indentation, to make it look pretty and more readable. It does make my code more readable, but that does affect the execution of my code as well. Remember, whatever is inside or indented is only executed if that statement's true. So this whole if statement of calculating the tax rate only is checked if the country is Canada. And when, if you are in Canada, then if the province is in this list, then tax is 5%. So in that indenting there of four spaces does change how the code is executed. So be very careful with that, especially when you start nesting if statements together. This might be a place where you might find it helpful to actually put that code into a function, just so you don't make mistakes on the indenting. And good news, we're going to show you how to do functions soon. So we've got a lot of different real-world business rules we can handle. And the more real-world it is, it seems the more complex the conditions apply. I'm going to show you now how we would do this inside the code.